Hello friends, in this video we shall see how to create your own header files. Header files are generally included as preprocessor directives. The compiler compiles the code of the header files along with the main program. Now we can write our own header files by including certain functionalities in those header files. Now there is a sample program that is given here. Okay, in the first box we have written a header, myheader.h. I have written two functionalities here, one is the add module and the other one is the mul module. Each of these functions is returning a plus b and a star b respectively. This is the main module. In the main module we include the header file. This is myheader.h. This code is saved as myheader.h in the file myheader.h, and this can be included in the main module just like we included stdio.h for using printf and scanf functions. So what am I doing here? I'm directly making use of this add function here without any definition. If you see the main function here or the main program, this is a .c program. I am using the add function without any function definition. So likewise, we can create header files in both C and C++. This is a sample which is shown here for C programming. Now we will save this file with the name probably program1.c, and we have included myheader.h here. Okay, and we have used the functionalities here. Okay, now you have to follow certain steps. Let's see what are the steps which you need to follow when you are creating your own header files. Okay. So include your new header file, and it has to be within the double quotes. Instead of, these are the standard header files which are included within these brackets which are given by the compiler. Now the header files which are created by the programmer have to be included within double quotes. Okay. Now once I include this, all the functions that are defined in the header file are going to be used in the main module. Okay. Now as we have seen in the previous example, we could call the function add directly without any definition. Now one important point which you should keep in our mind is the parameters and the return type should be known to the user when we are using these functionalities. Okay, and remember another point, keep both the files in the same folder. Okay, that is the header file and your main module. Okay, so this is how you can create your header files. Let me give you a glance of how it has been done. I have used the GCC compiler in Ubuntu. Okay, so these are the two files. Quickly I will show you the files which I have created. This is my header.c file. Sorry. The file which is created is my header.h. Okay. So I have written two functionalities here. One is add and the other one is mul. Okay. So both of them, each of them, add is returning the sum of the two numbers which are being passed as parameters here, and mul is returning the product of the two numbers which are passed as parameters. Okay. Let me show you quickly what is my C program. So this is the C program I have written. The name of the C program is prog1.c. Now if you see, I have included the header myheader.h within the double quotes. Okay, I have defined two variables x and y. These are simply variables and some initialization is done to these variables. And what I have done in these two printf statements is I have simply called these functions. Now if you see, nowhere in the main module I have defined the function add and mul. Okay, so as I have included this header file here, the code for these functionalities will be automatically picked up from myheader.h by the compiler. Okay, so in all the Linux flavors, the C compiler is available is GCC. So I simply say GCC prog1.c to compile my program. Okay, now the program has been compiled without any errors. To see the output, we use the command /a.out. Now what you see here is sum is 30 and product is 200. The numbers that were given were 10 and 20. So that's why the number is, the sum is 30 and the product is 200. Okay. So that's all. Now this functionality is very useful for the developers, because you can reuse the code. If somebody has written a functionality to, let's say, to find the factorial of a number, okay, I have written a recursive procedure which finds the factorial of a number. Okay, so let me put it in a header file, and I can reuse this code. Someone else who wants to build something using, like, he wants to build a program to find the the probability NPR or NCR. So he can make use of the factorial function directly by including the header file. So that saves the development time. That's why header files are very essential. And as a programmer, we need to know how to create our own header files by including various functionalities. That's all. Thank you.